Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So hello and good morning students. We are doing reciprocating pumps and the topic is the effect, the use of air vessel in reciprocating pumps. We've seen different topics worked and everything. We now will talk about the air vessel and its importance in this lecture. What air vessel is, initially through a diagram, then I'll discuss about the effect of air vessel and what are the benefits of using air vessel in a reciprocating pump. Let's see through it a diagram first of all. Now, as you can see in the diagram, I've drawn a reciprocating pump. Initially, when I had drawn the reciprocating pump, there was no air vessel in it. Now, you can see there are two air vessels. These are air vessels which are initially filled with air. So, it is a container which is made up of a certain material like cast iron or steel. It can be anything. So, it is filled with air initially, pressurized air. So, at the inlet of the suction pipe, when the suction pipe is about to enter into the pump, there's a pipe that is there is an air vessel, and at the discharge end also, when the water comes out from the pump, when it is in the delivery pipe, there is a container in which the air is filled. That is also the air vessel. So it is a vessel that is kept on the, that is attached on the delivery pipe and as well as on the suction pipe. So it is filled with air. Now the question arises is what it does. So air vessel is nothing but it helps in absorbing all the pressure fluctuations, it helps in absorbing all the discharge fluctuations that is taking place in the pump. So what happens is, suppose it is filled with air, the water is being sucked into the pump from the suction pipe. Now since as you can see here, there is a connection with this container, so the water first enters into this air vessel, and then after the air vessel is filled to a certain level, the water starts flowing into the pump. So the air that was initially inside the air vessel now gets compressed because of the water being full. Now since the water is filled here, the air gets compressed. Now what happens is, so the air is compressed inside the air vessel. Now suppose in case the pressure fluctuations happen and the compressed air now pushes the water and forces it to flow into the pump. So these fluctuations, they are absorbed by the air vessel. Similar is the case at the delivery side. The water that is being discharged from the pump first goes into the air vessel. It fills the air vessel, it compresses the air inside the air vessel, and then it starts discharging from the delivery pipe. Now in case again some fluctuations take place, some pressure fluctuation take place, some the pressure reduces, the compressed air now pushes the water from the air vessel. The water goes and maintains the fluctuation of pressure. Now again, in case the discharge is not continuous, suppose the discharge is intermittent. So there's discharge happening, there's some pause, again there's discharge happening. So what this air vessel does is, it maintains a constant discharge. So suppose the discharge is not continuous, the air vessel, the pressurized air in the air vessel pushes the water in the air vessel and makes the discharge continuous. So that is also the effect created because of air vessel. So the it has a lot of advantages, it doesn't have any disadvantage. Only problem is the pump becomes a little more bulky, it becomes a little more complicated. There are a lot of attachments created, but overall it helps to improve the efficiency of the pump. So it improves the efficiency, like it reduces the pressure fluctuations. The lesser the pressure fluctuations, the lesser is the pressure fluctuation, the more is the efficiency of the pump, the more effective the pump becomes. Also, it reduces the fluctuation of discharges, so the discharge becomes continuous. Also, the power can be driven by a crank which is connected to a motor. So there is pressure fluctuation which is absorbed by the air vessel. So that was all about this topic, air vessel. It has no mathematics involved in the air vessel. There's only a theoretical part. So that was all about this topic. I hope you've understood the concept of air vessel and why it is used and why it is installed in pump. So thank you so much.